In this video, we find out how using a sound blaster could be the key to stopping wildfires. Welcome to the channel. To understand how we could stop wildfires dead in their tracks using sound, we first need to get a better understanding of what wildfires are, how they start, and how we go about fighting them today. A wildfire is a wild, unplanned fire that burns in areas of dry vegetation like forests and open grasslands. They can happen at any time, but are more common after extremely dry weather, which leaves these areas vulnerable. All it takes is just one spark, and a roaring blaze is unleashed. Now, it's important to remember that wildfires are a completely natural and an extremely important part of the circle of life. Many plant species have evolved to use this to their advantage. Some seed pods only open up after a fire. But with the climate crisis causing more extreme weather patterns, the resulting fires are getting bigger and more unpredictable.
Devastating fires in Australia.
Firefighters driving through the inferno.
And in recent years, this has led to the catastrophic damage of both human property and natural spaces. One of the most infamous examples of this were the Australian wildfires of 2020, which wiped out an estimated 1.5 billion wild animals, not to mention countless livestock and numerous firefighter casualties. It took nearly 9 months to bring the wildfires under control, and even then, it was only possible thanks to rainstorms that came in at the very last moment. To be clear, this isn't a problem exclusive to just Australia. It's a global issue. And it's only thanks to the heroic firefighters who risked their lives amidst the blazing flames that were able to combat this problem. But the question is, how and where do they even start when it comes to putting out these huge fires in the first place? In short, it's far from an easy task. But with the proper techniques, there are several methods that can give our heroes an added edge. For wildfires that generate up to 1,000 kilowatts per meter of energy, these can usually be fought off directly by firefighters using hand tools and water-supported assistance. When the intensity of a fire is between 1,000 and 2,000 kilowatts, that's when the heavy machinery, water tankers, and water bombers come into play. They're used in a direct attack to control and extinguish the flames. Chemical fire retardants, which are typically dyed red to help keep track of the areas that have been treated, inhibit the ability of the fire to reignite after the water's evaporated. Wildfires with an intensity of 2,000 to 3,000 kilowatts require an indirect attack method. This involves building wide fire breaks as well as using water bombers, intentionally setting up fires to burn up as much dry vegetation ahead of the main wildfire is also highly effective. This is called backburning, as it burns back all the way to the actual wildfire. Now, once a fire reaches 3,000 kilowatts and above, it's officially exceeded the suppressible limit. At this point, firefighters redirect their efforts away from fire management and towards the preservation of life.
But hang on a second, if we've got all these techniques at our disposal, why do we need to bother wasting time and money on wacky outlandish ideas like a firefighting sound blaster? Well, it all comes down to understanding your opponent.
Although wildfires might be natural, the trouble is they're getting bigger, more intense, and increasingly are burning in unexpected places, including the Arctic. That last point is a pretty big concern, as our current techniques rely on the easy access of water, either from the coast or nearby lakes. Even areas that are used to having wildfires have seen a huge increase in how often they happen. Researchers have calculated that forest fires are now responsible for the loss of an extra 3 million hectares of tree cover every year. That's an area roughly the size of Belgium. When it comes to the increasing fire activity, climate change is seen as the primary cause. And when we look at the stats, it's clear to see why. We're now 5 times more likely to experience extreme heat waves than we were 150 years ago, and warming temperatures are only causing heat waves to become more and more frequent. With warmer temperatures come drier landscapes, creating the perfect environment for wildfires. And of course, more wildfires means there's more CO2 released into the atmosphere, adding to the warming greenhouse effect, which leads to more fires.
It's a vicious cycle that we're in desperate need of breaking. Thankfully, there just so happens to be one innovative and highly unconventional piece of tech that promises to fight wildfires in a very special way using sound waves.
If you're enjoying this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Liking this video does wonders for the channel and helps to spread this content to more people just like you. When it comes to using sound waves to fight fires, it turns out that the idea isn't anything new. The famous Irish physicist John Tyndall was one of the first to test out this theory back in 1857. Over 100 years later, the field of what's known as acoustic fire suppression began to pick up speed within the scientific community. In 2004, researchers at the University of West Georgia tested the possible use of sound waves to extinguish flames in spacecraft, where the lack of gravity makes water less effective when traveling in space. Then in 2008, the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, aka DARPA, launched their Instant Fire Suppression Program to explore radical new approaches to firefighting. They tried using sound as well as electromagnets, but it was the experiments that used speakers to blast sound at specific frequencies that produced the most interesting results. They saw that the acoustic field of sound had the effect of increasing the surrounding airspeed. As the airspeed or velocity increased, the flame boundary layer, where the combustion occurs, would start to thin out, making it easier for the flame to be disrupted. It wasn't until 2015 that two engineering students finally brought this vision to life by creating what they call the acoustic extinguisher. Seth Robertson and Viet Tran created their acoustic extinguisher as part of their senior design project. The original aim was to use it as an innovative way of putting out small kitchen fires, but they believe this technology could have a far wider impact, from use in airplanes, spacecraft, and of course, to fight wildfires. Their prototype is a portable handheld device that cost them just $600 to make. In the future, the idea is to develop the tech to create an integrated system that uses multiple acoustic extinguishers, sensing technologies, and drones to detect and contain wildfires. So, how does it work? The acoustic fire extinguisher appears to make use of two aspects of sound waves, which disrupt what's known as the combustion triangle. To start and maintain a fire, you need three ingredients: fuel, oxygen, and heat. Take any one of those ingredients away, and there's no triangle. No combustion triangle, no fire. This is exactly what makes the acoustic extinguisher so ingenious. Firstly, the energy from the speaker is effectively moving air back and forth, which in turn acts to push oxygen away back and forth from the source of the flame. Although there's still oxygen in the air, it's being spread over a much larger surface area than normal, so isn't stationary for long enough for the oxygen molecules to actually react with the heat and the molecules of the burning material. Secondly, thanks to something called the ideal gas law, we know that the temperature and pressure of a gas are directly related. This is why a pressurized spray can will start to get ice cold if it's sprayed for an extended period of time. A drop in pressure leads to a drop in temperature, which in our case starves the fire of that oh so precious heat. Armed with this brilliant concept, Seth and Viet began experimenting. They started out testing ultra-high frequencies of 20,000 to 30,000 hertz. This had the effect of making the flames vibrate, but they didn't go out. It was only after they switched to using lower bass frequencies of 30 to 60 hertz that they were finally able to put the fire out. Although the prototype device itself is relatively small, where DARPA failed, Seth and Viet succeeded by adding Vortex rings. These rings of low-frequency sound waves can travel much greater distances without losing the necessary energy needed to suppress the fire. The acoustic extinguisher is still in development, and although there's still the risk of having a wildfire reignite once the extinguisher's out of range, it does offer service personnel a potential brand new device to add to their arsenal of firefighting techniques. Further improvements could be made by combining the acoustic extinguisher with the latest in drone technology. Each drone could have its own specialized role. A fleet of sound-blasting bass drones could be deployed first to suppress areas of high-intensity fires. These would then be followed by a second wave of drones that would spray these areas with an actual fire retardant, buying our firefighting heroes the precious time they need to get these raging fires under control once and for all.
Wildfires will always be a part of how nature maintains the health of our forested landscapes. But until we can actively reduce the effects of climate change, these fires will continue to rage out of control as an extremely destructive force.
Combating this is of great global urgency, and it seems that advances in acoustic technology could be our greatest ally. And that's how a sound blaster could be the key to stopping wildfires.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that subscribe button and head to the comment section to share the ingenious ideas that you've come across too. For our offers and much more, head to the episode description below. And if you're looking for more great content, then check out this next video. Thanks for watching.